Okay, back for another video with just me. We're gonna cover another nerdy topic, because you know when you see me only, it's gonna be nerdy. This is how we use S-Log footage. And disclaimer, we are not professional colorists by any stretch. We make YouTube videos, but we have developed a workflow that works for us using S-Log on our Sony cameras that we've been using pretty much since 2016. And one of the most common questions that we get is, how do you edit and grade your footage? So without further ado, this is how we do it. So what is log footage? Without getting too technical, log refers to the way the camera records the scene in order to capture as much dynamic range as possible, which is desirable because we've now associated wide dynamic range shots as one of the many subtle visual cues that's associated with a cinematic look. So by this virtue, unedited log footage will therefore be really low in contrast and saturation in order to preserve that wide range of data. Then in post, we can add back in the contrast and saturation. This adjustment should be standardized and somewhat predictable, and it should be a simple, easy one step to get your log footage looking back more normal. So you can then start grading or stylizing your image. And this is where LUTs or lookup tables come into play. They're basically a standard set of instructions or a filter, if you want to think about it that way, that you can apply and basically take care of this conversion within your editing software. And this confuses a lot of people because everyone wants to know, how do I get these LUTs? Do I make them? Do I buy them? Which LUTs do I use? We had all these same questions in 2016 when we started shooting log on our A7S II. And ultimately we ended up developing our own custom S-Log 2 LUT. Since then we've developed a couple more for various shooting situations, but the bottom line is any footage that you see on this channel, it was shot in S-Log and it was run through one of our custom LUTs. I should mention that we didn't make these to be the most accurate or scientific LUTs, but rather the goal was more so to consistently get our footage to a good neutral starting point that's pleasing to the eye and was easy for us to grade. So what LUT you use depends on what camera and settings you're using. In the Sony landscape, they give you two log options, basically S-Log 2 and S-Log 3. So generally speaking, S-Log 2 is better suited for most of their consumer 8-bit cameras, such as the A6000 series, which we've got right here in the form of the A6400, the A7 III, A7 R4, etc. But if you're using a camera that can record in 10 bits or higher and has a higher dynamic range, such as the new A7S III, S-Log 3 is probably the best choice. If you want more info on this, there's way nerdier people that have done videos on this, so I'll link to that up here, AKA Gerald Undone. So since we have cameras that fall in both those categories, we've developed LUTs for both S-Log 2 and S-Log 3. So if you're using any Sony consumer camera that isn't the A7S III, then chances are you should probably be using S-Log 2. And we have two LUTs that will work with S-Log 2. We're using the A6400 here, but most Sony cameras are gonna have similar menus. So go into the menu settings, find the picture profile section and choose PP7. This should automatically set the gamma to S-Log 2, the color mode to S gamut, and the saturation to 0. The only thing we choose to change in the profile is the detail level from the default -7 setting to 0. A lot of people would rather add sharpening back in post, but I find leaving it at 0 looks fine, and quite frankly, I think it does a better job than I could do in post. Either way, this has nothing to do with S-Log, more or less, but it's just a matter of preference here. One of the other settings that we also would advise turning on is something called Gamma Assist. We leave this on auto, which basically normalizes how the footage looks on the back of your camera automatically, but it won't affect the log footage that's actually being recorded. This will help you gauge the exposure and the lighting of your shot on the back of your camera, which can be kind of hard to do if you've got this really low contrast, flat log look. So as far as camera settings are concerned, that's pretty much it. You shoot with these settings, our original S-Log 2 free utility LUT will work for you, and the link can be found in the description box below. So once you get your camera set up, you need to kind of figure out how to expose the image properly. And S-Log's a bit of a different beast. There's a lot of people who have done sort of deep dives into the why of this, but generally speaking, you need to overexpose your image about two stops.
That light just cut off.
But the light ran out of batteries in the back. Come on, Peckham. You're supposed to be manning these things. I didn't steal a cable. It wasn't me. So what I was saying is you need to overexpose by two stops, that basically two stops of what your meter is telling you. And this is mostly to keep your shadows clean and as noise-free as possible. If you want to get fancy, you can buy an 18% gray card and you can spot meter that to get your exposure nailed. But I find that after you do this for a while, you shoot log a lot, you'll actually just get really good at judging, you know, what a proper exposure looks like. Side note, just remember that on the Sony meters, that when it says +2, that's the highest the meter will read. So you could be at even like 5 stops over and it'll just blink +2. So don't let that confuse you. So what I find a more reliable way to do it is if you sort of dial the exposure back to plus 1.7 and use that instead. That'll make sure that you're not way overexposed and not realize it if you're just looking at the meter. I also set my zebras to the clip point of whatever profile you're using. So that's 106 for S-Log2. And you have to set that in the custom setting and then set the lower limit to 106. And by doing that, it will tell me what is definitely clipped in my scene, but I don't gauge my exposure by the zebras strictly. I more so just use the meter and eyeball it. I also stopped relying on my histogram, which was hard to do as a photographer because that's like the gold standard that you use for exposure. But I find in log modes, your image can be very overexposed, but the histogram can still deceptively be very central, making you think that you have a properly exposed image. So once you have your footage recorded in with the proper settings, now you can apply our custom original S-Log2 LUT. Before we developed our own, we were using one of Sony's S-Log2 LUTs that we liked. I think it was like the type A curve, but we found ourselves constantly having to tweak certain hues, particularly yellows, greens, magentas, and some of the skin tones. So we basically just ended up making our own custom LUT that takes care of all of those adjustments. And again, you can download that for free. Links in the description box below.
What's the description box?
Description box. Stop heckling me here, Peckham. So we use Adobe Premiere Pro to edit, but most software should have a way to apply a LUT file. In Premiere, I usually will create two adjustment layers, one for my log to Rec 709 LUT and any primary corrections that we might do, and then a second adjustment layer over the top of that for my grade, which can be applied usually to the whole edit. We use the Lumetri color panel, and then I'll apply our original S-Log2 LUT in the Creative tab. And I'll do that rather than in the basic correction section because many of the adjustments that you can do in the basic correction section, you want to be applied before the LUT is applied. So if you have a super high dynamic range scene and the LUT completely obliterates the shadows and highlights, I can make adjustments in the basic panel that can save some of that information before it clips out. Once you have your LUT applied, you can do your primary color correction by fine-tuning your exposure and white balance and really get the clip to a neutral starting point for your color grade. And I routinely find myself bringing the exposure down in this section a bit to compensate for the slight overexposure that we did at the time of shooting. So as for grading itself, we've done tons of videos on this, and we are firm believers that unlike converting log footage to Rec 709, there isn't really a one-size-fits-all solution when you're grading, so using LUTs to grade is a bit of a flawed way of thinking, in our opinion. I'm gonna link to some of the videos up here in the cards if you're interested in checking out how we grade things. That's a very massive topic that we've covered before in depth. Okay, so that's the workflow we've been using since really 2016, since we started shooting S-Log2. It was just shoot S-Log2, convert with our custom LUT, and then color correct slash color grade. But one of the major issues we found with shooting with consumer 8-bit cameras and using log footage is that there are side effects when making these massive color shifts in post or color adjustments in post. And what I mean by that is that it can bring out artifacts. So with Sony in particular, blocky green and magenta color noise in the shadows can be a big issue. We have found a fix for this though, and hats off to Dunna Did It, link to his channel up here for this idea, because he basically came up with this and we just sniped it. So we mentioned earlier that log footage records images with low contrast and low saturation, and that you have to add both of those back in post. But since the goal in shooting log is to really just maximize the dynamic range, most of the benefit comes from the contrast adjustment, not the color. So if we can record the color saturation as close to normal as possible, or as close to the intended level as possible, we can do a less aggressive color adjustment in post, and that should fix the problem of getting these artifacts popping out. So I did a bunch of tests and figured out what I thought the best settings were in camera, and then developed a new custom LUT that was basically based on our original S-Log2 LUT. And I can get an image that is virtually identical to original S-Log2 LUT, but without the color blocking. So if you're interested in that new LUT, we have it linked down in the description box below. It's called the, insert title here. What do we call it, Becky? Color Block Fix. Is it called the Color Block Fix? Is
that what that's what I called it. All right. Change the name of it.
So to use it, you're first gonna need to set up your camera properly. Again, we're using the A6400 here as an example, but most other Sony cameras will have basically the identical menus. So find the picture profile menu and choose PP7. This by default should have the gamma set to S-Log2, the color mode to S-Gamut, and the saturation set at 0. So the key here is changing that saturation to plus 24. And I did a bunch of tests with different saturation levels. I found plus 24 required the least aggressive adjustments in post, and hence is why I chose it. And as we mentioned before, we also changed the detail level from minus 7 to 0, as we find the in-camera sharpening does a decent job and it saves us from having to sharpen in post. We also recommend setting the gamma assist function to auto, which will attempt to normalize how the preview on the back of the camera looks when you're shooting, but without actually affecting the contrast of the log footage being recorded. And note that now that we've bumped the saturation crazy, the back of your camera is gonna look super hyper saturated, but there's not a lot you can really do about that. As we explained in a bit more detail earlier in the video, you'll wanna aim for exposing 2 stops over what your meter is telling you. We use the default multimetering mode and find it does a pretty good job in most cases. But if your scene is really dark like this one, I think this one was what? It's minus 0.3. Okay, so we're not even following our own rules. The issue is that this scene is mostly black, so the metering is getting a little bit confused. But basically, generally speaking, if you overexpose by a stop or two, you're gonna get cleaner shadows. Another thing I said is I set my custom zebras to the lower limit of 106, so I know what's clipped, but I don't use them to gauge my exposure. So in post, you need to apply the LUT, but of course this time around, you'll need to apply the new color block fix LUT instead of the original S-Log2 LUT. So this new LUT will fix the contrast the same as the original LUT, but performs a different, less aggressive color adjustment, which will avoid bringing out any of those blocky color artifacts. So as far as editing, I'll refer you guys back to earlier in this video on how we set up our timeline, but basically in a nutshell, we create one adjustment layer for primary correction, apply the LUT in the creative tab, and then use a second adjustment layer above that for grading slash stylizing. Okay, so if you're using a camera like the new A7S III that's better suited for S-Log3, we've developed our own custom S-Log3 LUT. What are we calling it? The A7S III. Line?
S-Log3 for A7S III.
We're just gonna put the title here. S-Log3 for A7S III. So we've created this to match our other Sony cameras that shoot S-Log2. So regardless of which camera we are using, whether it's shooting an S-Log2 or S-Log3, with or without the saturation fix, all of our angles will match as seamlessly as possible. Okay, so the first thing you need to do is set your camera up. Of course, as we said before, we're using the new A7S III. Find the picture profile menu and choose PP9. Make sure the gamma is set to S-Log3, the color mode is set to S-Gamut3, and the saturation is set to 0. And this is basically the default PP9 settings. One thing we do change though, as we said before, is we change the detail from the default minus 7 up to 0. As the camera we find does a decent job in sharpening, but this is of course up to personal preference. We also wanna make sure gamma assist is set to auto and custom set our zebras to lower limit of 94 to show us areas that are blown out. And this is actually different than the value we use for S-Log2, which is 106. And this is just a difference in the profiles. They, for whatever reason, clip at different levels. So as with S-Log2, you'll wanna overexpose what your meter is reading, generally between 1 and 2 stops. Gerald Undone has done a massive video which covers all of this and more, so I'll spare you the details. I'll just link to his video up here. If I've already linked to it up here, then I'll link down in the description box below. But he does a way deeper dive into all of that. So when you're editing in post, you'll then, of course, have to use our S-Log3 for A7S LUT.
3 for A7S3.
Jeez, I can't even get the names of these LUTs right. I'm just gonna say, you'll need to use our S-Log3 LUT, official name right here in the title. And then apply it in whatever editor you use. In our case, that's Adobe Premiere Pro. And again, we talked about in depth how we set up our timeline adjustment layers earlier. But basically, it's applying the LUT via the Creative tab on the first adjustment layer. The primary corrections can then be done in the Basic Corrections tab of the same adjustment layer so that it applies the corrections before the LUT is applied. And then a second adjustment layer that goes on top of all that can be used to apply your grade. Okay, so that is it. With our custom utility LUTs, we can reliably get a logged Rec. 709 conversion that matches our camera angles regardless of the camera, regardless if it's shooting S-Log 2 or 3, regardless of if it's using the color noise fix. Everything just matches. And these are all of our cameras. I'm gonna show this B-roll here that we regularly use, and you can pretty much see that they all match pretty well. Each camera differs a little bit on the magenta green tint axis, but with a tiny white balance adjustment in post, they're basically indistinguishable. Throw a little grade on that, and that's the final Becky and Chris look. I know a lot of you have been asking about our process, so this is literally the meat of our process here. Again, we've done a bunch of grading videos that we'll link up here or link down in the description box. But more importantly, a link to the LUTs that we're using is in the description box as well, including our free original S-Log2 LUT that we've been using basically since 2016. So if you like this video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and hit the bell so you get notified when we post new videos. We will see you on the next one. Bye. Yeah, palm that for me. Yeah, you palm that. There we go.